Welcome to a short tutorial on clip angle connections with SolidSteel parametric for Autodesk Inventor. The video is a supplement to the manual that you can open by clicking the help button in the tool dialog. Our demo assembly is a normal installation situation consisting of a large column to be connected to a narrow I-beam. Here, the connection could be made with an end plate, but it is not uncommon to use an angle connection as we will do now. The corresponding tool angular connection is located above, and in the dialog we see that the selection of two faces is expected as input. So we select one face and then the second connection face and immediately get a preview of our clip angle connection. The single angle option is checked and we see that there is no angle on the other side. We deselect this option because profiles of this size require a stable connection. The preview changes and the second angle is also visible. By the way, the arrangement of the angles is mirrored on the second selected face. Since the selected angle has two legs of unequal length, we can swap them with the sides flipped option. Now the long side is on the attached profile and the short side is on the column. We also have the international standards with different sizes for the angles and the profile selection. I'll stick with 180 by 90 millimeters with 10 millimeters material thickness. Only the height is of course too small, we can define it here. Maybe 400 millimeters, no that's too much, 340 millimeters should fit, yes that looks good. The angle is now exactly centered on the selected face. If we want to move it, we can do this with the offsets. Up and down, of course, using the z-axis marked in blue, and both existing angles will be moved in the same direction with the input. If we want to create a gap to the web, we can use the x-axis marked in red. Values entered there will move the angles away from each other on that axis. Okay, now let's take care of the whole pattern. We can define this individually for both legs. Let's just start with a single column at the bottom, and also just a single one here at the top. We increase the number of rows, for example to 4, with 60 millimeters row spacing. This is still quite tight. 80 millimeters spacing is better. Then we set the distance to the edge to 45 millimeters to move the holes to the center of the 90 millimeters leg. We set the number and row spacing below in exactly the same way. But here we set the distance to the edge to 90 millimeters to hit the center on the long leg again. Logically, we also have the option of defining the bolted connections twice, since we have different grip lengths, and can also create different bolt diameters. Clicking on Assemble opens the part selection and the grip length has already been determined. Now we define the screw by shape, standard and diameter, which we apply by clicking on Add, and clicking on Default Mountings automatically adds two washers and a nut that match the standard. The preview looks good, we can confirm and the fasteners are inserted. The dialog has also become larger because the components of the bolts are now listed. Now we define the bolted connection for the second leg of the angle. The steps are exactly the same, so I sped it up a bit for the video. The other screws are in place and our dialog has gotten even bigger. We now have a scroll bar, but you still can't see the bottom of the dialog. That's because I'm only capturing part of a larger 4K monitor. On a real 1080p monitor, the dialog would be scaled to fit. I confirm by clicking execute. Now just outside the image, and the double clip angle connection is inserted, including all components such as screws, washers and nuts, and the holes in the profiles have of course also been added. If you want to modify existing clip angle connections, you can do this with the same tool. In the dialog, switch to the Change tab and click on the connection to be changed. All parameters of the selected connection are now displayed and you can make any changes which have to be confirmed again with Execute. I won't do that now, because it's exactly the same as what we just did when we added the connection. Instead, I will show you how to remove connections using the Delete Connection dialog. This is also very easy to do by selecting the connection with a click and then confirming the deletion. If you want to know how to connect beams with end plates in SolidSteel parametric, just click on the video suggested here. Thanks for watching and see you next time.